Welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. As we start trigonometry, we want to get a few of the vocabulary terms out of the way. That way, as they come up over and over, you have a good understanding as to what these things actually mean. So let's go ahead and get started. Trigonometry by itself is the study of right triangles. And you may be familiar with what a right triangle is, maybe not, but we'll get there. But essentially, you're going to be seeing these objects, right triangles, quite a bit in terms of solving them, looking at their sides, and relationships that they have to other objects. Now, if we had to start somewhere, it's probably a good place to just start with what is an angle. You can form an angle by taking two rays, like these little lines here, arrows, and they share a common point. Now, usually we might actually mark out an angle using some sort of other variable. So I might say this is the angle theta. Now there's all kinds of different types of angles, and it depends on how big this angle is. Angles can usually be measured in degrees, radians, or grads. And again, it all depends on how big it is, whether we call it acute, right, or obtuse. In an acute angle, we are looking at angles that are less than 90 degrees. Less than 90 degrees. For a right angle, these ones are exactly 90 degrees. And these have a special notation since they show up quite often. We'll often put a little square right in the corner. And lastly, our obtuse angles, that's where we get angles larger than 90 degrees. Okay, so now that we know a little bit more about angles, we can start talking about them inside of a right triangle. So a right triangle is any triangle where we have one of the angles as one of these right angles. So that is 90 degrees. And we'll often talk about these other angles in relation to the sides. So maybe just for clarity, we'll go ahead and mark out these guys. We might call that one theta. Maybe we'll call this one up here. We'll give it another name. We'll call it beta. Now, in addition to, say, identifying the individual angles in this triangle, we also want to talk about the sides of the triangle. The sides are usually done in relation to one of these particular angles. For example, maybe I want to talk about this angle, and I want to talk about its adjacent side, its opposite side, and the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse will always be the longest side of the triangle, and it's directly across from that right angle. So let's just mark this as hypotenuse. In terms of the adjacent side or the opposite side, again, that all depends on the angle. So if this is the angle I'm talking about, this side right next to it would be the adjacent side. And then the side right across from it would be the opposite side. Now, of course, that could change. If I'm talking about this angle, then this guy would become the adjacent side, and this one would be the opposite. So it really matters what angle you're talking about. Now, once you have that out of the way, then you're in a perfect spot to actually talk about the trigonometric functions. These are things like sine, cosine, tangent. And at first, it may be a little confusing, like, what are these things exactly talking about? And it's all about pairing up the sides that you've identified and creating ratios out of them. So let's take one of these right triangles and see how this works. So here I have my right triangle. It's got a little right angle in the corner. And I'm going to be talking about this angle right here, theta. So I might want to talk about the various different sides in here. So adjacent is right next to it. Opposite, directly across from that angle. And of course, the hypotenuse is the longest side, or the one directly across from the right angle. So these trigonometric functions are going to pair up a couple of these sides. When it comes to sine, we're going to pair up the opposite and the hypotenuse. Opposite over hypotenuse. And notice how, since we built everything off of this angle, it really is identifying this as the opposite side. For our cosine, it's very similar, but it's the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. And we could also talk about tangent, which is the opposite over adjacent. So you can see these trigonometric functions are no more than the lengths of the side divided by one another, and we really have to specify the angles so we know which sides are really adjacent and opposite. Just so we have the rest of the trigonometric functions on here, let's go ahead and write them. So there's also cosecant of an angle. We have our secant of an angle. And we have our cotangent. These take care of the other pairings that you might have for these, such as, for our cosecant, we want to do the hypotenuse over the opposite. We got hypotenuse over the adjacent, and we have adjacent all over the opposite. So the exact reciprocals of the first three. Now there's many, many more connections in trigonometry among the trigonometric functions, but we'll get to those in some later videos. This should give you a good foundation when you start hearing these terms and you're trying to figure out, well, what are they talking about? It's usually just a lot of names of angles and a lot of ratios for the sides in that right triangle. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit mysecretmathtutor.com.